Good morning, students. Sairam. Let us continue with our Maths 1 online teaching session. In the previous session, I have started with arithmetic progression, that is chapter number 3. Today, I am going to continue further in this chapter. But before we do that, let us quickly recap of what we have already learned in the previous session. I have told you the definition of sequence. A sequence is a collection of numbers arranged in a definite order according to some definite rule. For this, I hope you remember, I have given you example of natural numbers, whole numbers, perfect square numbers. All those numbers were sequence. Then I defined arithmetic progression for you as, if the difference between any two consecutive terms is constant, then the sequence is called as an arithmetic progression. So main thing to understand here is that in AP, the difference between any two consecutive terms is constant, right? So let us continue further in this chapter. Now what we are going to learn today is nth term of an AP. Now what is the meaning of this nth term? Suppose I give you this set of numbers like 5, 8, 11, 14 is an AP. Then what will be the value of the nth term? Nth term means the last term. Now, where this numbers will end, that I don't know. Suppose I restrict it to 20. Is an AP where there are 20 such numbers here. Yes, these are only how many? 1, 2, 3, 4 numbers. Suppose I want to write numbers, 20 more numbers in this, right? That will be the value of n. Now, in AP, there is a formula to find the nth term of an AP. What is that? Tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Now, I will explain you each and every term of this formula, where A, I hope you know, that is the first term of the AP. Here it is 5. N means number of terms. D means the difference. Here the difference can be found out. The difference between any two consecutive terms is D. So, the formula is Tn is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. If I want to relate this to this example which I have given you, what is the value of A here? 5. I hope you can see this. Value of A is 5. What is the value of D? D can be found out by 8 minus 5. That is nothing but 3. So A is 5, D is 3. The formula is Tn is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. How to find the nth term then? In the place of A, what will I write? 5. Correct? N I don't know. So that will be written as n minus 1. What is the value of d? D is equal to 3. So substitute 3 there. Right? Now open the bracket here. What will happen? 5 will be as it is. 3 into n will give me 3n. Minus 1 into 3 is nothing but minus 3. So what do we get? 5 plus 3n minus 3. Further, this 5 minus 3n can be simplified as plus 2. Right? So what is that nth term of this AP? Tn is equal to 3n plus 2. This is what I was telling you to find the nth term. Suppose I restrict it to 20 terms. So what I have to do? I have to find T20, where this n is to be substituted as 20. In this way, we can find out nth term of any given AP. Okay? So the formula to remember is Tn is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Now with this, let us start with practice set 3.2. The first sum. Write the correct number. This is an activity based question. Okay? So write the correct number in the given boxes from the following AP. AP given was 1, 8, 15 and 22. Okay? So A was 1, that is T1. A is nothing but T1. T2 is 8, T3 is 15. I have to find out T2 minus T1. So as easy as 8 minus 1, that is 7. This is the first box in the textbook. You can see where the boxes are there, and accordingly you put the boxes. T3 minus T2. Again, what I have to do? I have to subtract 15 minus 8, which is nothing but 7. And what is the value of D here? That is common difference, 7. Okay, I hope you understood this sum. Let us move to the next sum. Now see this. Decide whether the following sequence is an AP. If so, find the 20th term. They are telling us the value of n here. How much? 20. Okay? Of the progression. And the AP given is minus 12, minus 5, minus 2, 9, 16, 23 and 30. Right? What should be our first step? To write T1, T2, T3, T4 and so on. So T1 is equal to minus 12, T2 is equal to minus 5, T3 is equal to 2. Right? T4 is 9, T5 is 16. Then, question asks us to determine whether this is an AP. What was the basic step? In order to determine whether it is an AP, you just have to find out the difference between any two consecutive terms. If it comes as a constant number, you can conclude that it is an AP. Correct? Okay, so let us find out T2 minus T1. What should I do? This is a second term and this is a first term. Minus 5 minus of minus 12. So what do you get? Minus 5 plus 12. Because minus into minus will become plus. Answer is 7. Same way, find out T3 minus T2. 2 minus of minus 5, which is nothing but 2 plus 5, again 7. T4 minus T3, 9 minus 2, 7. T5 minus T4, 16 minus 9, 7. So as you can see, that 7 is a constant difference which we are getting. Yes, so common difference is 7. If the difference is constant, the given sequence is an AP. So you have to conclude that therefore the given sequence is an AP. Now what are they asking us further? Hence find the 20th term. Now I know the value of n here, that n is 20. A we have got as minus 12, D is 7, and n value they have specified 20. Okay, so I have given you the formula of Tn is equal to A plus n minus 1 into D. This is the formula which I told you to find the nth term. And in this sum, n is nothing but 20. So wherever you see n here, you have to substitute 20. Okay, so let's see. T20, see, and in the place of n, I have substituted 20. In place of a, I will substitute minus 12. Plus, n is again 20. Minus 1. D is how much? 7. So 7 can be substituted. So let us evaluate it. Minus 12. 20 minus 1 is 19. Correct? 19 into 7. So 19 into 7 is 133. So minus 12 plus 133. Subtract this. Answer is 121. And 133 is a greater number with plus sign. So it will be plus 121. So the given sequence is an AP is the first part of the answer. And the 20th term of an AP is nothing but 121. I hope you understood this. This is a way to find any nth term of a given AP. Let us move to the next sum. Now, it is exactly similar to what we did just now. Yes, I hope you have understood that and you can do this sum on your own. See this. It's given that this is an AP, right? What they want us to find out? The 24th term. You don't have to find whether it is an AP or no. It has already been specified here that it is an AP. What you need to do is just find the common difference. Once you get the difference, use the formula, substitute the values and get the answer. Okay, so A here is the first term, that is 12. B is nothing but 16 minus 12, that is 4. Formula, Tn is equal to A plus n minus 1 into D. Now, what is the n value here? They want us to find the 24th term. So T24 is equal to, substitute the values, 12 plus 24 minus 1 into 4. So 12 plus 24 minus 1 is 23 into 4. How much? 92. So 12 plus 92 is 104. Okay? So it was similar to the first sum. The 24th term is 104. I hope you have understood this. Let us move to the next sum. See, all are similar type of sums. Have a look at this. Nothing different. AP is given to you. They want us to find out the 19th term. Exactly same way. It's an AP. So no need to prove that it is an AP. It is already given. Find out D, which is 6. Yes, T2 minus T1, 13 minus 7, that is 6. Then again use the same formula of Tn, that is A plus n minus 1 into D. Now what? Let us substitute the values. A is 7. N is 19, 19 minus 1 into 6. I don't have to tell you anything extra in this. It is straightforward substitution in the formulas. 18 into 6 is 108. Add 7 to it, you will get 115. Okay? So the 19th term is 115. I hope you are understanding this easy sums. If these type of sums are asked, it might come for 2 marks. Okay? Let us move to the next sum. See, similar type again. Fifth sum of 3.2. Find the 27th term of an AP if this is an AP given. Exactly same way. Find out difference. That is T2 minus T1. How much it is? 4 minus 9. That is minus 5. Once difference is found out, use the formula. Tn is equal to A plus N minus 1 into T. Then substitute here. A is how much? Look at the sum. 9. Then N. They have asked us which term to find out? 27. So 27 minus 1. D just now we have found out as minus 5. Correct? 27 minus 1 is 26. Which I need to multiply by minus 5. So plus into minus, of course, it will be minus. And 26 into 5 is 130. So 9 minus 130, which is nothing but 121. And 130 is a greater number with a minus sign. So answer will be minus 121. Correct? So the 27th term of the AP is minus 121. Okay? Now we come to the next sum. That is the 6th sum. This is an important type of sum. How many 3-digit natural numbers are divisible by 5? Right? Now, how to relate such questions with AP? First thing is, for an AP, what we need? A sequence. Correct? A given sequence we need where the difference is constant. Now, in this, there is no sequence given to us. So, our first step will be sequence. How to get that? They want a 3-digit natural number. Natural number, so only positive numbers we have to consider. That to 3-digit, which are divisible by 5. Now look at this. Let us start remembering. The 3-digit, the highest, the greatest 3-digit natural number is 999. But that is not divisible by 5. Yes or no? The smallest 3-digit number is 100. Yes or no? 99 is 2-digit and 100 is 3-digit. Is 100 divisible by 5? Yes. So, for the sequence, 100 will be the first term. Since it is to be divisible by 5, the next number obviously should be 105, 110. Now we go back. I told you 999 is the largest 3-digit number. But since it is not divisible by 5, we don't have to consider. Moving ahead, like 999, then 998, even that is not divisible. 997, 996, all these numbers are not divisible. But when I come to 995, is it divisible? Yes. So this is the greatest 3-digit number divisible by 5. This is the smallest 3-digit number divisible by 5. So in this way, we can get an sequence, an AP, right? Where A is 100, D is 5. See this. This is the last term. This is absolutely not N. This is the last term. So this is the first term. This is second term. This is third term. Like this, this is a last term. I need to find out which term is this. Means I need to find out N from here. How many numbers are divisible? It means I need not. Very many students get confused between Tn and N. So this is a last term. This is not N. I need to find out value of N. Okay? Formula remains the same. Tn is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. I know the last term is how much? 995. Yes, A will be 100. Should I substitute N also as 995? Absolutely not. N is a value which I need to find out. Tn is 995. N is not 995. N I need to find out. Okay, N minus 1 and D was 5. Okay, so substituting these values, we get this. Next step is to simplify it further. So 995 is equal to 100 plus N minus 1 into 5. So, shift this 100 to this side first. So, it will become 895. And open the bracket here. 5 into N is 5N minus 5. Then what? Shift this minus 5 this side. It will become 895 plus 5 is equal to 5N. 895 plus 5 is what? 900 is equal to 5N. Correct? So, shift this 5 on the other side. You will get 900 upon 5, which is nothing but 18, right? So final answer will be what? There are 183 digit natural numbers divisible by 5. Okay, so this way you have to write the final answer. What you need to understand is the difference between n and tn. Tn is the last term of a given sequence, and n is the value of this, whether it is the fifth term or sixth term or seventh term. Okay, so do not get confused between this. I hope you have understood this sum. Okay, next sum. The 11th term and the 21st term of an AP are 16 and 29. Find the 41st term of this AP. Now this is an important type of question. 7th question of 3.1. Now how to start this? From where to start? We will start this sum from this term. The 11th term means what? T11. Correct? The 21st term means what? T21. What are they given? Values as 16 and 29. So 11th term is to be written as 16 and 21st term is to be written as 29. From where? From the first part of the question. Right? What are they asking us to find? The 41st term. In order to get this 41st term, I should know what is A, I should know what is D. N I know that it is 41. Right? So I am going to first find out A and D. This should be my first term. Once I get this, I'll substitute in the formula and get this 41st term. Okay, so to start with, we know the formula. Tn is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. After this one, no other information is given except that T11 and T21 are 16 and 29. So that at least that much we will substitute. N is equal to 11, right? So in place of N, I will write 11. A will be as it is. N again will be 11. Minus 1, D will be as it is because we don't know what is A and D, correct? But we know the value of T11. T11 is given as how much? 16. So we will substitute that. 16 is equal to A plus 11 minus 1, that is 10D. Equation number 1. Exactly same way, we will try to get the second equation. From where? From here. T21, right? T21 is equal to A plus, in the place of N, I will write 21 minus D. Minus 1 into D. Okay, so 21 minus 1 is 20D, and T21 is how much? 29. So 29 is equal to A plus 20D. This will be my equation number 2, right? So now equation number 1 and 2 we have got. These are two equations which can be simplified by subtracting. Yes or no? So let us simplify it further. So subtracting equation 1 from equation 2, when we subtract, we change the sign. So obviously, this 16 will become minus 16, A will become minus A, and 10D will become minus 10D. So A and minus A first step will get cancelled. 29 minus 16 is nothing but 13, and 20 minus 10 is 10D. Okay, so either you leave D value as 13 upon 10, a fraction, or you convert it into a decimal as 1.3. Your choice, you can do by anyway, any method. Okay, so one thing I have got, that is D. Now what I want is A. If I get A, I'll use a formula and get the 41st term. So how to get A? Substitute D in equation number 1. See this. 16 is equal to A plus 10 into D. And D was how much? 1.3. That is the reason I have taken D as 1.3. 10 into 1.3 is nothing but 13. You can take even 13 upon 10, where that 10 and 10 can be cancelled. Your choice, you can do by any method, right? So A will be, 13 can be shifted this side, 16 minus 13, that is 3. So we have got D as 1.3, A as 3. Now what we want in this sum is 41st term. I know the formula, Tn is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So T41 will be, substitute the values whatever you have got. A was 3, correct? N is 41. 41 minus 1. And D was 1.3. Right? So 3 plus 41 minus 1 is 40. 40 into 1.3 is nothing but 52. So 3 plus 52 is 55. Okay? So the 41st term of an AP is nothing but 55. This is the final answer. So what we can conclude from this? when such questions are asked, where two terms are given, you need to get two equations first. Once you get two equations, get the value of D. Then substitute and get the value of A. When all these things are done, you have to go to the term which they are asking us, whether it is 41 term or any other term which they are asking us, substitute properly in that and get the final answer. So these are the steps to be followed. It is little bit lengthy. If asked in the exam, it will be asked for 3 marks. Okay, so I hope you have understood it. And the next question is, which term of 11852 is -151? Now look at this, what they are asking us, which term of an AP. It means they are asking us the value of N. Which term? Term means N, right? Then what are the things given to us? Have a look here. A is given as 11. What is this? -151. This is TN value, the last term. Okay? D can be found out from here. Then what we need to find out? Which term? Term means N. I need to find out the value of N. Okay? So let's see. A is equal to 11. D is equal to T2 minus T1. That is 8 minus 11, which is nothing but -3. Tn is -151. Exactly same way, use the formula, substitute the values. -151 is equal to 11 plus n minus 1 into d was -3. Then what? First step is to shift this number this side. So it will become -11. -151 minus 11 is -162. Correct? And open the bracket here. Instead of opening the bracket, you can write it as it is and then shift this -3 also this side. So -162 upon -3, minus minus getting cancelled. 3 ones are and 3, 54s are. Correct? So 54 is equal to n minus 1. Shift this n this side. N will be, shift this 1 this side in fact. So n will be 54 plus 1, that is 55. I hope you are understanding. It is similar to what we did in the previous one. Only difference is, here A is given, D is given, and Tn value was given. What I need to find out is N. Okay? So the nth term is minus, or the 55th term is -151. Any way you can write, the value of N is 55, or the 55th term is -151. Okay, then with this we come to an end of this session, where we have done few very important sums. Based on this, I have prepared this assignment questions, which I want you to sincerely do on your own and try it. See this, the last one, how many 2-digit numbers are divisible by 6? Think about it, how it is to be done. What is the first 2-digit number divisible by 6? Should I take 6? No. It is 1-digit number. So the first 2-digit number divisible by 6 is 12. Then 18. Correct? And then you proceed further. What is the last number you think? And accordingly you do it. I have given you hint how to do it. Right? So I hope you have understood whatever we have done today. Solve these assignment questions. Okay? And we'll continue in the next session. Thank you.